I'm Christina Astin from Physics Partners, and in this short film we're going to look at how to teach the transfer of energy by radiation. The film is part of a short series to help you with your physics teaching, especially if you're new to physics or new to teaching or just looking for some new ideas. I'll focus on the common misconceptions that students have and give you some tips for introducing this concept, especially if you're teaching remotely. Feel free to pause, take notes or rewind and watch again. Many students find it confusing that we use the term radiation for energy transfer alongside conduction and convection, and also for ionizing radiation or radioactivity. And they can also find it difficult that objects which are dark or black are both good at emitting and absorbing radiation. The fundamental thing to remember, of course, is that energy always moves from the hotter end of an object or in a hotter object to a colder object. Whether it's by conduction, convection or radiation, it's always moving from a higher temperature to a lower temperature. And when an object warms up, it starts to emit electromagnetic waves, beginning with the long wavelength, low energy waves, radio waves, moving through microwaves and infrared until eventually it glows visibly through red and then up through the spectrum. And then really hot objects emit ultraviolet, X-rays and gamma rays. Usually those are restricted to really hot objects like stars. When we talk about energy transfer by radiation, we're usually talking about infrared waves, such as those emitted by this hot cup of tea. Now the tea is cooling down by conduction, convection and radiation. Conduction, well, I can feel that the sides and the bottom are hot. And I know that the solid that the cup is made of is transferring by conduction as the particles jostle and pass on their vibrations. I can also feel the warm air rising above the hot cup of tea, and there's convection going on through the tea and also a little bit of evaporation too. Convection takes place in fluids, liquids and gases, because when they get hot, they get less dense and they rise. But how would we convince students that the cup is also emitting infrared radiation? Well, I can also feel warmth to the sides, even if I'm not touching the cup. And infrared radiation, all electromagnetic radiation, can travel through air and travel even through a vacuum. That's how, of course, the sun's radiation reaches us here on Earth. So what affects how quickly an object can cool through radiation? Well, there are three factors. The first is temperature. The hotter it is, the more it will radiate. The second is its surface area. Objects with a greater surface area emit more radiation and cool quicker. Think of elephant's ears. And the other factor, perhaps surprising at first for students, is the colour of the object's surface. Black or dull surfaces emit radiation faster than light or shiny ones. There's a link at the end of the video to help explain that. So here I've got two cans, one black and one white. And if I put the same volume of water in each at the same starting temperature, I can then see how quickly they cool. After a few minutes, you should be able to feel the difference, but you could also check them with, say, a kitchen thermometer. The black one cools faster because black surfaces emit radiation, radiate energy better. Or if you prefer, the white one stays hotter because it's less good at emitting radiation and so it keeps its temperature. Now, here's a baked bean tin that I've sprayed half with black and half I've left shiny. And I can fill it with hot water and then the sides at the same temperature all the way around. But this side, the black side, feels hotter at a distance because it's radiating more than the shiny side. So that was really a homemade version of the GCSE required practical involving a more sophisticated tin called a Leslie's cube. It has four sides with different coloured surfaces. Here's an infrared sensor and a meter. When we put hot water into the cube, all the surfaces are the same temperature, and then we keep the sensor at the same distance from the cube and we can measure the infrared radiation emitted by each surface. So colour affects the speed of radiation. Students may well be shown an unfamiliar example in an exam, so it's good to get them discussing lots of real life situations to help embed this concept. Shiny surfaces are poor emitters, so a kettle should be shiny so that the hot water stays hot. If we're looking after someone after a marathon or mountain rescue, we give them a silver blanket to help retain their body temperature and stop them getting hypothermia. This object is a heat sink. It's a lump of metal inside a computer which is in contact with the microchip, and it radiates away the heat from the circuits in the chip, keeping it cool. It's painted black and the fins increase the surface area. And this is the back of a fridge. It's also painted black and the squiggles give it lots of surface area so that it can radiate away the heat that was picked up from inside the fridge. You may have come across concept cartoons, which are a great way to help draw out students' misconceptions, getting them discussing physics and helping them to change their understanding. In this example, the characters are discussing what colour a solar panel should be. You can decide who's right, who's wrong, who's partly right or partly wrong before offering your own explanation. Well, of course, black surfaces do radiate more energy. We've just seen that. But they also absorb energy the best. Now, how are we going to explain that to our students? In the previous examples, all the objects, the kettle, the heatsink and so on, were hotter than their surroundings. And in this slide, we'll look at objects which are, at least initially, cooler than their surroundings. So they are going to absorb energy. A dark car, for example, gets very hot on a sunny day. Solar panels should indeed be black so that they absorb more energy. White would simply reflect it away. And that's why tennis and cricket players tend to wear white to keep cool when playing summer sports. And houses in hot countries are often painted white for the same reason. So how do we help our students understand that objects with a dark, matte or black surface are better at both emitting and absorbing energy? We must remind our students that energy always moves from hot objects to colder objects. If an object is hotter than its surroundings, it will radiate or emit energy. If it has a dark surface, it will do that better. If cooler than its surroundings, it will absorb radiation. If dark coloured, it will do that better. Shiny surfaces just reflect the radiation. Here's another concept cartoon for you to consider. So if you'd like to pause the film, you can have a think about what they're saying. To help with answering exam questions, it can be useful to point out to the students the key words that give a hint that the question is asking about radiation as opposed to conduction or convection. Well, I hope that's been a help in teaching this topic. Here are the links to the concept cartoons I showed you and some other useful resources. Hope to see you again soon.